There are many new AI tools that allow you to build websites and software just by prompting them. This AI tool go and build everything from the front end, meaning the user interface, right, to the back end, including the workflows and the database. You can do it by using third-party tools, connecting them to these AI tools. And one such tool that I will be talking about today is Bolt.New, a fairly new AI tool that helps you build everything from single landing pages to full-blown SaaS just by using prompts. The cool thing about Bolt.New is that you can just do it using prompts. You don't have to know how to code. You don't have to drag and drop. Only using prompts you can build software. Today, we will be doing a full walkthrough, a full tutorial on exactly how to use Bolt.New. Whether you are a beginner or you have been using it for a while and you want to learn some tricks, this video is for you. Now, why am I doing this video? The issue that I see is that many people look at these tools and they think they are complicated, hard to use, or that you need to know how to code in order to use them. And I can tell you that based on personal experience, I don't know how to code. I can tell you that none of this is true. It's actually the opposite. All you need to do is you need to understand how to build the prompts that will trigger your desired end state. And that's all you need to be on your way. Of course, you at some point you will want to learn how to code, perhaps because you want to understand what the tool is doing and perhaps to fix some of the issues that it produces for data security and everything else. But it's not a requirement to start. It's just if you were starting to use Bolt today, you can start building and learn as you go. And that's the magic of these tools. So with that being said, today I will be giving you a full walkthrough of Bolt.New. In this tutorial, you will learn the basics of using Bolt, including some of the features that you may or may not be aware of, especially if you have been using Bolt.New for a little bit. And the goal is to help you start with Bolt after this tutorial for you to go and start crafting your prompt and using them to build something nice. And you are perhaps not going to start by building a SaaS application, but at least you get going and you start understanding. And while this is not my last video on Bolt, it will be your starting point. After this video, you should be on your way to start building using Bolt. And I will be honest with you, if you want to improve your skills, I recommend that you smash the subscribe and notifications button on my channel so you get the latest tutorials I release them. I will be releasing tutorials fairly frequently from now on, perhaps every other day about what I'm learning. And the next one will be how to connect Supabase to Bolt. So you will want to hit the subscribe button and the notifications button. Also, if you like this tutorial, I ask that you help me spread the word by clicking the like button so the algorithm knows it's a good video to recommend to others. With that being said, we're going to jump in and we're going to start exploring what Bolt has to offer. The first thing that you will want to do is you want to go to Bolt.New. I will leave you the link down below in the description, but if you don't get it from there, all you have to do is Bolt, B-O-L-T dot N-E-W, new, and that will take you to this landing page. If you're watching this over the Thanksgiving week, meaning between today and Friday, today's Tuesday, and between today and Friday, they're doing 2 million tokens for free, so that's really nice of them. But if you go a different time, they may or may not be running a promotion, I don't know. With that being said, you will land in this page. This is where you enter your prompt. So you can enter any prompt that you need, or you can start with one of these prompts down here. So you can start up like Astro, Scaffold UI with Shadow CN. You get the point. You can click on any of them, and that prompts the system. It takes you exactly start working on it. We're going to let it run for a little bit, and here you see it. And you can connect your device and then it goes from there. I don't even know what it's doing right now, but I just click a run. Okay, so it was going to be a mobile app. Cool. And you can also start by selecting a technology. So you can start by using React, NativeScript, and Next.js, so on and so forth. That's a way to start by selecting which technology you want to use. Now, the way I like to start is by typing my prompt. And the reason why I like that is because I like to be a little bit more specific in regards to exactly what I need. I'm going to open Notion and I have a prompt here. And I will leave this prompt down in the description below, which you can use, maybe not. Actually, we're going to use this one. This is a good way to start. So what I'm going to do is, I'm going to actually copy this, paste it here. And we're going to copy the whole prompt and we're going to paste it there. So we're going to build an overview of what this project is. So I'm going to go to ChatGPT because I had a conversation earlier yesterday. Startup ideas. We're going to figure out which one is the one that I wanted to use. Okay, we're going to use this one. I just selected a random one. All right, we're going to go back to Bolt and we're going to paste that for teacher to share. I need a dashboard page, a settings page, and a login and sign up page. All right, like I said, you can explore on this prompt down in the description below. We need to change a few things. We're actually going to take this off because this is for a different project. Now, one quick thing, I just click enter. You cannot click enter as you're typing your prompt. You want to click shift and enter if you are on Windows, or shift and return if you're on a Mac. And I'm on a Mac, so for me it's shift and return. If not, you will be submitting your prompt. Actually, we're going to delete this because I don't want to confuse it. Interactive data. Lessons management and supporting user authentication. Again, we're going to delete this because I don't want to, and I will work on this and I will leave it in the description. Yeah, this is going to be gone. So now we have a decent prompt that will not confuse the system. So we're going to hit either enter or you can hit the blue button here. Now, I'm going to copy this because before doing that, I want to talk to you about these two buttons down here. The attachment button, in which you can add a design that you might like for it to use as inspiration. And this other button is to improve your prompt or enhance your prompt. If you click on it, it's going to rewrite the prompt in a way that it makes sense. It's actually doing a really good job, so I will be using the enhanced prompt. I recommend you that you use the enhanced prompt feature because the enhanced prompt feature doesn't cost you anything. We're going to send the prompt and we're going to let it do its magic. Right now, what it's doing is writing the code. It's going to create all the folders that it needs to store all the CSS, JavaScript, and anything else. It's going to start any dependencies that it needs, meaning it's going to start any technology that it needs in order to make sure that your website is functional. As you can see, it's creating folders for components, navigation, libraries, and everything else that it needs in order to make sure that it's building exactly what you need. Now, it's going to show you a preview. If it has any issues, it will tell you and it will give you an idea of what it is, and you can ask the AI to solve it for you. So we're going to All right, so nothing is displaying, as you can see. So we're going to tell the system, I don't see anything on the preview page, please fix it. Let's see how this enhances. So please check the preview page. All right, so there are two problems, two issues. So let's solve one. I see this error. What I did is I copied the error and I pasted it. So it's missing several components. So this is a lot of trial and error to make sure that it has everything that it needs. First thing that it's doing is make sure that it's adding all the components that you need. So as you can see, it created and updated some of the components that you need in order to display in your new application. So it's working right now, and the way it's because it's still writing code. It created a brand new folder right now, still in the waiting game. Once we preview it, then we will talk about other features. All right, so here we have, let's see what we got. We got a hero section for the landing page with a button that doesn't take us anywhere, neither does the dashboard or the settings. What we're going to do is, so there are 15 issues right now. I'm going to ask to attempt to fix those issues. And the reason why it prompted those issues is because I'm clicking buttons and it's giving me 404. So it's, oops, I forgot to create this. No big deal. The system recognizes that those issues happen and now it's working to fix them, which at the end of the day is what we want. And we want to make sure that we get what we need. And with that being said, and this is just for full transparency, I am on the free plan right now. As you can see, it is building everything that we need only using the free plan. I'm not saying you have to stay on the free plan or stay on the free plan. I believe that perhaps if you're going to be heavily using this, you need to subscribe. I will be subscribing, but it's really powerful and they have offered a really generous free plan that allows you to get the most out of this. So right now there is a problem. We're not going to fix it yet. Let's see what we get so far. Right now we have a dashboard. There is a sharp placeholder and we can start adding stuff as we go. There are 24 lessons, 573 downloads. Let's take a look at the lessons. So introduction to fractions. There is a download button that will trigger a download if we really had on that. Source system exploration, creative writing workshop. All right, that's cool. There is a settings page, really simple, just for the profile settings. That's cool. And the search bar doesn't work. That's fine. Let's take a look at the code. Let's close the components, hooks. All right. I think I drove my point home when I said, hey, these are the things that we have, we can do. Now, few things that I want to talk about is down here, you can continue prompting it. So I would say perhaps as an example on the settings page at this or at that, and it goes and does it for you. You can download the whole package. If you download the package, it downloads into your computer. And then from there, you can upload it to GitHub or whatever the case is. So it downloads as a zip file. You can open it in Stackblitz, which is their mother company, and that allows you installing the dependencies. That allows you to do folder editing. They got cool software. And this is more of IDE, so you can actually code from here. Still downloading dependencies. But we're going to go back. You have a terminal, so you can prompt anything that you need to prompt from the terminal, and you can add more terminals as you need it. There is a menu option for you to go to any individual file within your project. And there is a way for you to deploy into Netlify. And for you to deploy this application, you just click the deploy, and it builds everything that you will need to deploy to Netlify. But we're not going to do that, so we're going to stop it. With that being said, you can keep this project private, or you can share the link, and only those that have the link are able to access it, or it can be public where anybody can access your project. There's also the sidebar here where all your chats will be accessible, so you can go back and reference any chats that you have had with the system. There's a settings page, and there's a way for you to upgrade, which is here. 10 million tokens. There's a whole bunch of errors. 10 million tokens cost $20 per month, bill monthly. And in all honesty, this is a great deal when you take in consideration the cost of a software developer. I want to close this and go back here. You can use this in light mode or dark mode. I love dark mode, so I will keep it dark mode. And they have docs that you can use. Like I mentioned before, I will be doing a tutorial on how to connect Bolt to Supabase. So stay tuned for that. And now that we have reached the end of this video, I really hope that you have learned how to use Bolt.new a little bit better, and that these video tutorials serve as a starting point for your future project, whether that is building landing pages or building a full-blown SaaS or a micro SaaS perhaps. So this is probably the first tutorial that I do full-blown on Bolt.new, but this is not going to be the last. So if you like my tutorials, if you like the way that I teach, if you want to stay up to date with what's new with Bolt, I ask you that you smash the notifications button. But before doing that, you need to subscribe to my channel and to make sure that you're getting all the videos that I'm publishing. And not only that, I will say that if you like this video, please click the like notification so, you know, the algorithm knows that it can recommend my video to other people. I would really appreciate if you do that. Other than that, thank you for watching. I hope that you get the best out of this, and I hope to see you in the next video, and have a great rest of your day.